In the previous lesson, we learned how to change certain properties of objects, such as their color, their line type, their line weight, and the transparency. All those properties, along with more features, can be found in the properties palette. Firstly, I have to select an object from the drawing. In this example, I will select the rectangle. Then, I will right-click and from the menu that appears, I will select the Properties option. The Properties palette appears automatically. I will click on the right side of the palette and drag it to the left until it's docked to the side of the application window. Now I can study the contents of the palette. In the upper side of the palette appears the type of the object that is currently selected. As you can see, the rectangle is considered a polyline. In General Properties, we can identify general features of the object, such as the color, the line type scale, the line weight, and the layer the object belongs to, among others. We can change any of these properties by either expanding the list with the available options, or by entering a new value in the desired field. For instance, I will expand the layer list and I will select the zero layer. Notice that the rectangle belongs now to the zero layer instead of the center lines layer. Another interesting thing is that in the geometry properties, we can find the area and the length of the object, which is quite useful in closed profiles. Now I will press Escape to unselect the rectangle. When no objects are selected, only the current settings of general properties are displayed. If I select one of the circles, apart from the general properties, I can also find the coordinates of its center, its radius and diameter, as well as the perimeter and the area of the circle. Naturally, I can change any of those from this palette. For example, I will change the diameter from 26 to 22. So I will type the number 22 and press Enter. The diameter changed automatically. I will click on the Undo icon from the Quick Access toolbar to reset the circle's diameter, and at this point I will select the hatch. This time there are the general properties that do not differ from the other object's properties, and the hatch's properties which have to do with the pattern of the hatch. I will change the scale to 2, and the difference is visible. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention that if more than one object are selected, only their common properties are displayed. To get a better idea of what I mean, I will select 3 circles. Notice that in almost all the geometry fields, the word varies appears, which means that those values are different for each circle. Now, if I add the hatch to the selection, notice that the properties that appear in the palette are even less and most of their values vary.